The table below shows scores on a math test, and we're asked to complete the frequency table for the math scores. So this is our frequency table. Notice how we have two columns, where the first column lists the categories, in this case, all the possible test scores. We may also see this as equal intervals, but in this case, we just see the scores. And the second column is the frequency, which will give the number of times each data value occurs from our data list. And now we'll go through the data and put tally marks each time a data value occurs, and then we'll sum the tally marks. It doesn't matter whether we go down the columns or across the rows. Let's go ahead and go across the rows. So notice here we have 90, 90, 50, 100. So 90, 90, 50, 100. The next row we have 70, 60, 60, 80. So 70, 60, 60, 80. Next, 80, 90, 50, 30. So 80, 90, 50, 30. Next row we have 100, 100, 100, 90. So three 100s, 1, 2, 3, and 190. Next we have 80, 100, 80, 100. So 80, 100, 80, 100. And finally we have 50, 80, 70, 90. So 50, 80, 70, and 90. And now we'll sum our tally marks. So notice for 30 we have 1 and 40 we have 0. So the frequency for 30 is 1. The frequency for 40 is 0. For 50 we have 3, and for 60 we have 2. So the frequency for 50 is 3. The frequency for 60 is 2. The frequency for 70 is also 2. Notice the frequency for 80 and 90 are both 5. And finally, the frequency for 100 is 6. So I think to keep things organized, it is important to cross off the data values as we tally them for the frequency table. I hope you found this helpful.